Hi, everybody. My name is Jordan Oliver, and I am just honored to get to share a little bit of my testimony and just the powerful and unexpected ways that God has been moving in my life. Because let me tell you, I never in a million years would have imagined that I would have been led into ministry, or, you know, even be given stories like the ones I've been given to share. And it really has just all happened one step at a time, I'd say over a period of about 8 years. So I did grow up in a Christian home. And so I did know Jesus from a young age, but I never really learned about or understood about the gifts of the Holy Spirit and just how real God's voice can be to us. He was always a friend to me and always close, but as far as listening to his voice and having my life really guided by that voice, that's what started to become so real for me. And I'd say that happened around college time, when I was in college. And I'll never forget this one experience where I kind of realized that. And it was late at night, and I was walking back from the library, going back to my dorm room. And all of a sudden, this butterfly flew next to me. A butterfly at night. And I knew, I just had this feeling, and this is the only way I know how to describe it. It was just a feeling that it was the presence of God, that the presence of God was there. And it caught my attention. And from that moment, I always associated butterflies with God's nudge to me saying, pay attention, because I'm speaking to you right now. And I love to share that, because I feel like a lot of times we think God's going to speak to us in these huge ways, and it doesn't have to be. Most times it's through the very simple everyday things, like a butterfly. So I started hearing his voice. Well, at the same time that I was really starting to step a little deeper into my walk with God, I have younger twin sisters, Madison and Taylor, and they were having their own experiences with the Lord. And so they would call me and say, Jordan, well, I just had a dream about this, or we were just praying together and I had this vision. I saw a picture of this. And when we were reading the Bible, we found out that, you know, some of the prophets in the Old Testament, we were reading about similar visions they had, or we were getting confirmations through scripture. And so we were like, wow, this must be the Lord speaking. We have to pay attention. And the coolest thing was, even though we were all hearing God in our own ways, these messages usually connected somehow. And it all had to do with healing for either individuals, well, mostly for individual people. And so we just said, Lord, what do you want us to do with this? And we heard him say, I'm calling you into a healing ministry. And so we had no idea what that looked like, but we believed. We said, okay, well, we're just going to keep following. And so years went by, and we just, you know, we really, as I like to say, we stayed behind the closed door. You know, that's from scripture. You make your requests known to God behind the closed door. And we just had that time where he was really working on us individually. And then in 2017, he called us to move to Nashville, Tennessee. And it was in Nashville where we really got training and equipped with learning about that these are gifts of the Holy Spirit, and really learning how to use these tools to really help more people, and, you know, to be more confident in what these experiences were. And it was from that time on that Triple Braided Cord was birthed, which is our ministry, and it is an intercessory prayer ministry based off the Bible verse Ecclesiastes 4:12, which says one person standing alone can be attacked and defeated. Two can stand back to back and conquer, but a cord of three strands is not easily broken. And since there were three of us, we said, oh, we're the triple braided cord. This is our verse. But God was also showing us, you know, for everybody, that even if you feel alone, that triple braided cord is the Trinity, God, Father, Holy Spirit is always with you. And when you do partner with that, when you come into agreement with the Lord and just simply just accept him into your life and simply believe he's for you, you will be unbreakable, unbroken, because you start to look back and start to understand and realize how he has pieced together every single thing that you have experienced in your past, and how indeed it is working ultimately together for your good, which the word tells us. So it was really interesting because we actually started off speaking in schools. That was my history. I had worked in the school system for 4 years. So we started what we called School Tour of Hope. And we wanted to go in schools and teach middle schoolers, high schoolers about hearing the voice of God and just kind of trying to get them amped up about how exciting this can be. And God, as much as that was a good thing, God halted that after we got a couple school invitations. And he gave me this prophecy in the middle of the night. It was in 2018, February 7th, 2018, to be exact. And a prophecy is just, it's a word from the Lord. When you hear from the Lord, and it can be about a future event or it can be a word for somebody. And it's just divinely coming from the Lord. And he spoke to me this prophetic word saying that the nation, the United States was a sick nation and that he was about to do heart surgery in a spiritual context on the nation. And he gave me 12 particular states and a word for each state and said, the heart surgery is coming, but it's going to ultimately bring healing. Healing is coming after this. And so that was the first time we had ever received a word that wasn't for an individual person. Now this was broader. And we said, what are we supposed to do with this? This is a word for the nation. So we held on to it. And I like to say that too, when I tell my story, is that a lot of times if you hear a word from the Lord, and it doesn't have to be a direct word from God, it could be maybe a desire of your heart that you really feel God has given you or a vision he's given you for the future. It does not mean it's going to come to pass right away. And he always has a timing for that. And a lot of times we have to wait. The waiting process is where most of the good stuff happens because he's preparing us for it. So we held on to this. We had no idea what to do. And it was about 8 months later, which in really wasn't that long to wait compared to what it could be. It was October of 2018. And he said, he just through the three of us in our prayer time, he kind of directed us to look back at that word. He said, pull that back up, look at it. And you need to get back home quickly. Because like I said, we have moved from the Baltimore area to Nashville. But now he said, you get back from Nashville to Baltimore quickly. And we knew it was urgent. It was urgent. So we decided, okay, we're moving back home. We still had no idea why, but it was after that obedience, just blindly trusting what he said, that he then revealed the mission to us. And he said, this will be your mission for 2019. You will travel to one of these states each month, because there were 12 states, 12 months in a year. Go as the disciples went. Don't worry about money. Don't worry about where you're going to stay. Just go. The doors will open and watch what happens. So all of 2019 happened. We called our prayer tour for the nation. So we always joke and we say School Tour of Hope quickly turned to Tour for the Nation, you know, in a matter of a month. And we went, and through God alone, the doors opened. I mean, we didn't have connections in half of these states, you know, and so they opened and we went, and some gatherings had 40 people and some had 8 people. And the number did not matter. He said, these states need to be prayed into. And so we ended with New York City in December. We were there right around New Year's Eve. And it was just unbelievable to us as we looked back with 2 months after that, here comes the outbreak of COVID. And not only that, but the epicenter in the US was none other but New York City. And we could see prophetically, you know, how the Lord had aligned this and why the urgency, why he told us we needed to return quickly. Because if we would have waited another year or, you know, put that off, we would not have completed the mission. We would not have made it to these states. And then the lockdown would have happened and we wouldn't have been able to go anywhere. And we felt that as we were watching all the chaos come out and with the pandemic and everything, we had, yes, there were times of, you know, where we were like, what's going on, Lord? We thought you were saying healing's coming, you know, and we were a little confused, but we ultimately had that hope. We were able to hold on to that. The Lord spoke about this ahead of time. He said the nation was sick and that ultimately it was going to be healed. He was going to bring healing. And so it has been, you know, it's been amazing because we're still able to make connections. We're actually working on a second book about this, and we're waiting for him to release it. But I just hope that above all, this can be a message of hope for you, for whoever's listening, that, and it doesn't just have to be about the times we're in, you know, also about personal things that we're each going through. The heart surgery, when the body's sick and it goes through surgery, like physically speaking, it normally has to get worse before it gets better. That's part of the healing process. But if you can hold on, and if you can keep your eyes focused on God through it and just stand, sometimes you just have to stand through it, not even fight and be, you know, you don't even have to feel courageous. I think sometimes just standing is enough. The healing will happen. This too shall pass. And so I hope that can be just a little bit of encouragement to you. And, you know, I have hope. I have hope for everything that's to come because of what the Lord spoke. So I just want to thank you all for listening. And if you want to hear the stories of the states, we have a lot of our testimonies from these states on our website, braidedcord.org. And yeah, please check it out. But I would just love to say a prayer over you before signing off here. So Lord Jesus, I just praise you. I praise your holy name, God, for every single person listening right now, Lord. Lord, there is no timing that has not been set in motion by you, Lord. And so I know they are here. They are listening right now, Lord, because you brought them here, God. Lord, whatever they are going through, I just pray, God, that your voice just speaks to them in a new way, in a way that they have never experienced or heard you before, Lord. The way that you moved with the people in the Bible, God, it is for us today. Miracles are for today. Healing is for today, Lord. Hearing your voice is for today, God. And that is what I pray for each individual here, Lord, that you show them a mighty move of your spirit in a way that radically changes their life, God. Whether it's something through something simple like a butterfly, God, or whether it's through a big, miraculous healing that they've been needing, Lord. Let them feel your hand upon them, God. Let them know that they are not alone, that healing does come after the sickness. A sick body goes through surgery, but that is only to lead to healing, Lord. Give them that hope, Jesus, and lead them through any trial, through the darkest valley, Lord, whatever hardship they're facing. I pray that they feel your hand grab them and pulling them through it, Lord. We know that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot overcome it, Lord. It cannot overcome it. We seal these prayers up in the blood of Jesus and by the fire of the Holy Spirit. And we just thank you, Lord, for this day. Amen.